Shaku here from RealPars. I'm here with Mamila from Siemens, and she's going to share with us a new feature of S7-1200 PLCs that is going to be released on December, you said. Can you explain a little bit about that, elaborate what is this new feature and what we can do with that?
Yeah, of course. Well, we have so many new features that are coming in December. And actually what is coming is the firmware 4.4, and with this comes more possibilities for communication. For example, we have MQTT in order to have communications with the cloud, with different kinds of cloud, MindSphere, for example, or other third-party clouds, it's possible. And also we have OPC UA server as a part of these new communication features.
Yeah. So what I understand is that, like, with the new update that we received on December, we are going to be able to connect the S7-1200 PLCs to the cloud as well. Before that, like right now, S7-1200 PLCs, you cannot connect them to the cloud, right?
Yeah, no, right now it's not possible. But if our customer has a version of PLCs that are from before, 4.0, 4.1, can be updated.
And if you have like a CPU version 4, you said, 4.0?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, 4.0. You need to upgrade it to 4.4, right?
Exactly.
Yeah, upgrade it, and then that makes you able to connect your PLC to the cloud as well. And also, you mentioned that there are different ways of like upgrading your firmware for your CPU. Can you probably mention that in the video as well?
Yeah, of course. We have different methods. For example, the easy one is just to download the file and paste it, copy and paste it in the memory card.
Yes,
and then
which
you
is
can
here.
Insert the memory card in the
CPU. You don't
CPU.
Have a memory card here yet, right? You can just download it and just copy it on the memory card and put it in here. And you need to put it in here for like 5 seconds, and then you're done, and the CPU is has been operated. And then you also mentioned about OPC UA, the new feature. When you upgrade this S7-1200 to version 4.4,
able to communicate by OPC UA.
So this is also a new feature. Like with the old CPUs of S7-1200, you won't be able to communicate over OPC UA. But with this new update, you will be able to do that. And she also mentioned that in our conversation that this OPC UA makes you able to connect with other control systems in other factories, right?
This exactly.
This is the advantage of using OPC UA.
Exactly.
Can you elaborate that?
Yeah, sure. OPC UA is a machine-to-machine communication, and actually this comes from this new wave of digitalization, the Industry 4.0. So this is why not only Siemens but all the brands are trying to communicate with this protocol, because that means that we are going to be able to communicate our devices with third-party devices.
For example, if you have like in our factory, for example, if you have like Siemens, and then in another factory you have ABB or you have Rockwell, you will be able to, if the controllers are able to communicate over OPC UA, these two factories will be able to talk to each other, right?
Exactly.
Okay, perfect. Is there anything else that we can learn from this setup here?
Well, the DCPU is for basic application, it's the basic controller, but that doesn't mean that it doesn't have a lot of features, because the features that we are showing right here are the technological functions that come included with the CPU. We have in the inputs, for example, high-speed counters, PTOs, PWMs. We also have a specific library to add PIDs, for example, and it's really easy. We just have to set the set points and set the maximal
PID controller
and minimum value. Values, and that's it.
And that is specific to S7-1200 or like other PLCs?
No,
like other
all
CPUs.
Our controllers can be those.
Yeah. Okay, perfect. Thank you very much
you
for sharing the knowledge with us and the viewers.
My pleasure.